everyone. I am Mrs. Wood, and I am the counselor here at Sugar Creek Elementary, and I have a very special person with me today. If you want to introduce yourself.
Hi, my name is David Ryan, and I am from Mrs. Short's 6th grade class.
Good. Well, today we are going to talk about Brody's Bench. It's a dedication that we're doing that has a lot of special meaning behind it. But first, I want David to tell everyone what the original idea for the bench was.
Well, the original idea of the bench was just to be a bench. You know,
just where would it be? Where were you thinking the bench would go?
Well, like in the exact same spot.
So out on the playground?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, so then it went from just being a bench on the playground to
Brody's bench.
What about Brody's bench? Can you tell me more about it? Like, how'd you get that idea?
Well, I was coming home one day and my mom told me that, or about Brody's passing. And I did not know. And when she told me that, I just changed my focus from a normal bench to Brody's bench.
Very good. And we all know Brody Stevens was a student here at Sugar Creek Elementary for several years. And last year, when he was in second grade, he lost his battle to leukemia. And it was just obviously a difficult time for everybody. But David took an idea, an original idea that you had to put a bench on the playground, to Brody's bench. And so now it's a special time of the year because Brody's birthday is coming up and we're going to be dedicating Brody's bench to the playground here soon. But I believe you had to collect a lot of things to get the bench. So tell me about that.
Well, we had to collect 450 pounds of caps. And
450 pounds, not just 450 caps, but 450 pounds. Oh, that's a lot of caps.
Yeah. So with my grandmother Jane's help, we put a bucket in the cafeteria and I would go around every lunch and pick up the caps. And then every Friday I would bring home caps.
Wow. That's a lot of caps. And so then I believe you guys wanted to make your effort bigger. So then where did you go and how did it get bigger?
Well, we were sorting caps at my grandmother's house and my mom took a picture of me. And we had like 3 big black trash bags.
Oh.
And we poured them all on the floor. I got in the middle of them. And my mom took a picture, and I said, post that on the New Palestine
Facebook
page. Uh-huh. And my mom put on there, if you have caps, we still need more.
Good.
And once that happened, every day when I came home, we would have caps on our front porch.
And I believe you and your mom decided, or grandma, one of the two decided that you guys started calling it something. So if you'd come home and the bags would be on your porch, what did you say?
We would say, well, when we got home, we would be like, oh, we got capped again.
We got capped again. So that's pretty fun. And so as you would get more and more caps, I'm sure.
Yeah.
How did you have a lot of people help you? Like, did you meet people in the community to get caps dropped off?
Yeah, we met in gas station parking lots, the church parking lots, and McDonald's every single Thursday. So there were these old ladies at McDonald's that were always there. And one day, my mom asked them if they can start collecting caps. And so they did, and we started calling them the McLadies.
Instead of the old ladies, I think that's better.
Yeah, the McLadies. And, you know, if we couldn't meet them, then they could, you know, come drop them off at our house.
Very good. So, and I know that the Sugar Creek PTO had to pay for the making of the bench as well as the color of the bench. Because what color is the bench? It's orange and black, which was Brody's favorite colors, as we know. One last thing I want to make sure that we talk about is your experience. What did you learn from this experience?
I learned that we live in a great community and that if I set a goal for myself, I can accomplish it with hard work and, you know, if you need something like making a bench, just ask the community.
That's a very good point. I wanted to say how proud we are of David, that he not only am I proud of you, but the whole Sugar Creek family is so excited about the bench, and they're very proud of you, the students and the staff, and the parents as well. You've given a great example of being a good person and just setting your mind to something and making it happen and giving back to your community and to your school. So we just want to thank you very much for that.
I'm glad that I got to do this.
So are we. And we just want to make it a great time to honor Brody and just to let everyone know he's still in our thoughts. And we just appreciate everything he gave to us as well.